let's look down the road 3 months. There'll be about 5,000 campuses across the country trying to welcome 20 million college students, 100,000 public schools welcoming 50 million students. What would you say to the Chancellor of the University of Tennessee, Knoxville, or the president or the principal of a public school about how to persuade parents and students to return to school in August? Let's start with treatments and vaccines first. Dr. Fauci, and if you could save about half of my 5 minutes for Admiral Giroir for testing, I would appreciate it.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. Well, I would be very realistic with the chancellor and tell him that when we're thinking in terms—
It's a her in this case.
Oh, okay, I would tell her, I'm sorry, sir, that in this case, that the idea of having treatments available or a vaccine to facilitate the reentry of students into the fall term would be something that would be a bit of a bridge too far. As I mentioned, the drug that has shown some degree of efficacy was modest and was in hospitalized patients, not yet or maybe ever to be used either yet as prophylaxis or treatment. So if the issue is that the young individuals who will be going back to school would like to have some comfort in that there's a treatment, probably the thing that would be closest to utilization then would likely be passive transfer of convalescent serum. But we're really not talking about necessarily treating a student who gets ill, but how the student will feel safe in going back to school. If this were a situation where we had a vaccine, that would really be the end of that issue in a positive way. But as I mentioned in my opening remarks, even at the top speed we're going, we don't see a vaccine playing in the ability of individuals to get back to school this term. What they really want is to know if they are safe. And that's the question that'll have to be due with what we discussed earlier about testing.